met a guy named Tony Cabana. He was a guest skater on our one of our alumni games, and we hit it off right away. He got involved in my bowling event, and a few months after that, he asked me if I would be interested in going down to Virginia Beach to meet some of the Naval Special Warfare community that he got to know through the Navy SEAL Foundation. And the story is interesting because he got involved with them after watching Lone Survivor. He was so moved by the movie that he started doing research, and he figured out quite quickly that maybe not enough was being done to recognize these guys or help them out. So he made a cold call to the Navy SEAL Foundation, called the CEO right up and said, "I'd like to get involved." She called him right back and said, "Come on down to Virginia Beach, I'd love to meet you." And over the course of the next year or so, Tony, through his relationship with Cross Insurance, he's a VP at Cross Insurance, took some Gold Star families up to Patriots game, let them carry out the game ball, and really got entrenched in the Navy SEAL Foundation. So he's sitting with the CEO, Robin King, one day, and he sees a hockey puck on the desk. He says, "Hey, what's that all about? I play hockey, tell me about it." Well, the Navy SEAL Foundation had been supporting a hockey program in Virginia Beach run by Naval Special Warfare and a few of the Navy SEALs. And they were supporting that program because of its benefits to the community and their families. Tony went down and met with the hockey program. He played in a couple of memorial games honoring two SEALs that were part of the program that were killed in Afghanistan. He came back supercharged. And he asked me if I would go down with him to play in that game the following year. So I reached out to Bob Beers and said, "Hey, Beersy, I'm going down to participate in the game. We're trying to maybe build them a better locker room because there's no facilities in this particular locker, no ADA compliance. There's a whole laundry list of things." Bobby and I went down, met the community. We saw how important hockey is to these warriors, not only the special forces, but all military, because Virginia Beach is the most dense military concentration in the country, all branches of the service. So there are Air Force, Navy, Army, Marines, Coast Guard guys playing in this hockey program. We saw how important this is. Hockey helps them reacclimate and decompress after coming off a tour. When they're deployed, other team members will take their kids, bring them out on the ice. There's a sled hockey program. It helps with sleep deprivation. The laundry list of how important hockey is to this community is long. I came back from that visit supercharged, and I started reaching out to all of our alumni and said, "Hey, look, there is something special going on in Virginia Beach. We need to be a part of it." I talked to Rick Middleton, talked to Bob Sweeney of the Boston Bruins Foundation. And this past summer, Bob Sweeney, Rick Middleton, myself, Kenny Hodge Jr., Bruce Crowder, Tim Sweeney, and Dave Jensen went down with our wives. And with the support of the Boston Bruins, we helped run three hockey clinics, youth hockey clinics for all ages. The Bruins put on a big barbecue for the families. We gave out street hockey equipment to all the kids. It was a fabulous event. The next day, we played in their memorial hockey games. So it's interesting. The year previous we went down, there were maybe 30 people playing. Second year we get out, now there's 50 people. Word got out, and it was such a moving experience because you're playing with military members, both male and female, their children, their wives or spouses, and it's such a family-oriented community down there, and hockey is special. So, you fast forward a little bit. Their program is so successful, and their rink is so small. It's a converted grocery store, and they don't have enough room to expand in the property. We are helping them, one, try to grow the program, and to do that, we need to raise funds to help them build a new hockey rink. What we're doing on October 26th is we're bringing in the New York Rangers alumni to play the Boston Bruins alumni at Bentley Arena at 1 p.m. It's a beautiful, state-of-the-art, platinum LEED certified facility, holds 2,200 people. We really want to bang it out. So if you'd like to come watch Ray Bourque, Rick Middleton, Brian Leach, Joe Mullen, three of those guys are Hall of Famers, Rick should be. and Adam Graves, and the laundry list of people goes on. Bob Beers, Andy Brickley, Andrew Raycroft. We've got a great crew playing in this game, all to benefit the Warrior for Life Fund and the Navy SEAL Foundation. And what's been heartening through our efforts, and it's fairly young, we're only 6 months into this thing, when we reached out to key sponsors, Harvard Pilgrim, Health Plans Inc., Tufts, all New England-based insurance companies who support military causes, they were on board in a matter of minutes of our meeting. They said, we're behind this, we want to get involved, and they are supporting us with resources and contacts and reaching out to their communities. I also want to thank the Bruins Foundation, Boston Bruins Foundation, Bob Sweeney, who have really picked up this event and helped drive it as a key part of their overall philanthropy that they do, helping children's causes in New England, and in this case, down in the Virginia Beach, Norfolk area. It's been a godsend to have them involved. And I can't not thank the New York Rangers for their involvement. They jumped on board. The Boston Bruins alumni, they're on board. And the upswell of interest in this event and the cause is dramatic. We've got Nesson that's going to come and cover the game on Saturday. We've got 98.5. Thank you, 98.5, for all the support you've given us. The Boston Bruins alumni and their media staff has been tremendous. So if you want to be part of the cause or part of the game, please visit warriorforlifefund.org, where you can buy tickets. Military and first responders and their family are free. So please, we want to pack this building. Tickets are available if you walk up at the door too, but if you register early, you'll be sure to get in the building and get on the list. It's a tremendous event. We hope to see you on Saturday, October 26th at Bentley Arena.